Welcome to Monday Night Raw. Michael Cole alongside Corey Graves and Byron Saxton.
You can feel it in the air, Cole. Something wild's happening tonight.
You know what they say, Corey. Anything can happen in WWE, and tonight should be no different.
Oh, baby. Big E got to bounce back
from last week's loss to Monty Brown. WWE Universe is not really a fan of Big E right now for walking out during the middle of the match.
Oh, this is going to be a good one. You know, I've been waiting a long time for this, Byron.
You and me too, Michael. I've been dying to see this match.
I'm going to tell you one more time. If you hit me, I'm going to punch you right in the face. I swear to God.
Well, I think this superstar wants to punch his opponent in the face. What? Wait a minute.
Oh, nowhere to go.
What the hell? Big E still trying to duck and dodge?
Let's fight. Big E set for competition here tonight. Looks as focused as he ever has, maybe even more so.
We know Big E knows how to turn it on when the lights shine bright, and tonight is no different.
Oh boy.
Big E to be feared. Certainly a big
I'm not trying to be going against Omos.
Yeah, but have you seen Omos? Just look at him. What are you supposed to do with a guy like that?
I think that's just disrespect right there. Corey, Big E is such an imposing presence, something that can weigh heavily on an opponent's mind. So what do you think the key is to really take the fight to him? For as intense and powerful as he can be, Big E has a tendency to get lost in the power of positivity or whatever you want to call it. And that can cost him at the absolute worst moment.
Oh my God, no fucking way you have a counter to everything, bro.
Strength and now just pressing. And a drop.
Oh, Big E avoids contact.
He went right into that turnbuckle. Omos able to counter. He deflects it right back. Quick to the gun.
Omos with great awareness.
This is
sky high.
Smoke
from the heavens by Omos. Big E's
show you just never know what your opponent's capable of. When your opponent can hang after all that, you're wondering if running a win might just be impossible. Incredible elimination from the big man. Looking for the victory. 2-2. No, 2 count. I am in shock. What's it going to take to keep this guy down? Oh, no. Getting in position. What's he planning to do here? I'm not quite sure this man shouldn't tap out. This is about career longevity. And he very quickly counters. Into the corner now. Stop after stop. Relentless. Oh my God. Pendulum. Here he goes for the win. And he kicks out of the pin. One.
Right now, I just don't know what it's going to take.
We all know what Omos is looking for. Just like that, Biggie finds a cat.
Hello? No fucking way. Stunned. Can I get out of this? Jesus fuck, man.
What a smack. That is just insulting. Oh, nothing fancy with that boot. Oh, Big E avoids contact. Whoa, even harder impact. He's getting a huge boost right now from all those chants and cheers.
Like how do I hit this? I just want to know how. I just want to know how.
With a win like this, things have got the taste a little bittersweet right about now.
Actually, Saxton, I imagine the win tastes a lot more like pennies.
We know Ronda Rousey's mantra to be a true champion is to be better than the competition, even at your worst. She's proven before that those aren't just empty words.
It's always empty words until she's able to prove it again, Cole.
Corey, you're welcome to tell Ronda that yourself.
I'll pass. Appreciate it, though.
Yeah, I didn't think so. Ronda Rousey out here tonight to prove she's better than her competition.
And then you have someone like Mandy Rose. I mean, there's no one like Mandy Rose, but you know what I mean. Physically dominant from her strength to her looks.
Yeah, Mandy certainly has an understated, almost effortless approach to her strength and power game that you definitely do not see among many of her peers.
Oh, right to the kidneys.
Golly.
And Mandy Rose connected nicely right there.
World's worst combo.
Reputation precedes her. So how can one get an in-ring advantage against someone like the baddest woman on the planet who seemingly has all the advantages going into this match?
Oh, don't even think about trying to outstrike Rousey or going hold for hold with her. I mean, that's just asking for trouble. An overlooked part of Rousey's game is her quickness. Slow her down. Prevent her from getting any momentum if you really want a chance of eking out win.
Uh-oh. Knee lift to the body. Nice. Mandy Rose with the instinct to counter. Right to the leg. Ooh, look at her answering back.
I can't throw you. I cannot. I literally cannot Irish whip you. Wow. Like, that is ridiculous that I can't even do an Irish whip without an auto counter. Look at this. Look at this bullshit. Referee, what are you trying to do, bro?
Maneuver their body out of this submission, dropping bombs, and they're free.
Mandy Rose, hooked up. Roses. She's looking for the win. And referee cuts off the count in one.
No time to waste being shocked. You've got to maintain pressure.
Able to beat Mandy to
Rope break.
Is over. Oh my god. Oh, thank goodness. Thank goodness. That could have been disastrous.
I look like Danny Burch from outside of the ring here.
I think it's safe to say this issue is far from resolved. He's ready to go. This is a big match. Big match for this young man. Could find his way in title contention with a win tonight, and
he doesn't look like he's ready for action, I'll tell you that.
No, not at all.
Was the match going to happen or not?
Good question.
The WWE Universe just exploded.
Oh, Mr. Perfect 10. John Spears, the chairman.
And his opponent from Calgary, Alberta, Canada, weighing in at 252 pounds, Sean Steele.
One of the most dangerous and threatening individuals in all WWE.
On that, we can agree, Cole.
Well, the WWE Universe doesn't sound like they agree.
Well, they also don't sound like they have two brain cells to rub together between the thousands of them, Saxton.
That's not nice.
Superstar that has all the tools to be one of the biggest names this business has ever seen.
I'm not ready to crown him as the next big thing just yet, but his performance in this match could sway me.
You're not the only person he'll be looking to convince tonight.
But guys, look at Seth Rollins. He's always been a serious competitor, but more often than not, he's in a foul mood, and he usually takes all that anger out on his opponent.
I won't argue. Seth's gotten a little rough around the edges, but I think it's a dramatic improvement,
and he could have had a three count in hand. Question this decision.
That's a good way to make your presence felt.
Oh no! Now possible submission maneuver. It's not an embarrassing attack. A single leg camel clutch and a great counter. Hoisted up. He's feeling the effects of that last hit. If he can hold the line here, he'll be in a good position.
Oh, whoa, Falcon Arrow.
Yeah. Lined him up, boom.
Ooh.
Down, ouch.
I've noticed that sometimes Seth Rollins can look a little overconfident in the ring. Is there a way to turn that arrogance against him?
Oh, absolutely. Seth's confidence in his own abilities can lead to him leaving himself vulnerable for big attacks because he drops his guard to gloat. I think if you watch Seth closely and find the right time to attack when he least expects it, you get a great offensive opening.
Was only in better position, that would have been three.
Rollins just a step too slow. Oh, look at the knee strikes. One after the other.
That shoulder targeted there.
Just punched him right in the mouth. Relentless.
Enough already.
He had it scouted.
absorbing some tough hits now. Yeah, Cole, but at this point in the match, you still haven't lost the edge. Elbow drop right on point.
Oh, look. We're about to see it.
Oh, no fucking way.
Turnbuckle now. Impressive reversal on Rollins. Reversal on top of reversal. Series of reversals. How's that for a counter? Terry finds his mark. It's a good one. His defenses have fallen, and soon he may too.
Maybe just stay down, man. You've done enough.
No, no fucking way with this counter bullshit, bro.
Lined him up, boom! Knocked him down, ouch! Making that shoulder a priority. Double underhook applied. Up and down, blam slam. Free fall.
Oh my God. Yeah, resiliency, that's bullshit, bro. Complete bullshit. I'm so there. Bullshit, 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 that magic pixel. Bullshit.
Escaping danger. Single leg drop kick.
Another rope break. Imagine this bullshit. Another rope break from hell, bro. Like, I've had like the worst luck with Rollins where like I just cannot put matches away because of bullshit counter states. Fucking resiliency bullshit on every fucking character here. And then for some reason the pedigree just does not hit every single fucking time. This fucking pedigree, dear God. Dear God, I'm hitting this pedigree for the third time. Dear love, for the love of God, I'm hitting this goddamn pedigree.